I'm Jim Slaughter. I'm the owner of Minicab Racing USA. This is our new Micro Hydro for Minicab Racing USA. MinicabRacingUSA.com. Comes ready to run with the water-cooled brushless motor, speed control, and servo, outdrive, prop. It's all set up.
Let me see that outdrive, Jim.
Everything is extremely high precision.
That's aluminum, isn't it?
It's all machined aluminum.
It's machined. That's pretty fancy stuff.
It's a water-cooled motor.
It's water-cooled.
In-runner brushless motor, water-cooled. You see the water jacket right here. And all you have to do is add your own receiver and battery and go race. Now these two boats, that's one of our other team boats here. This is John Otto, one of our racing team members.
Afternoon, John.
How you doing today?
You're the oiler, I see.
I'm the oiler.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And
this is the same boat, Jim?
Yes. Different color. They come in seven different colors. They come with the antenna. Everything you see, they do not come with any graphics on them, so you can decorate the boat any way you want. This is the way we've decided to decorate our team boats. There's another third team member, unfortunately couldn't be here today. He's running a blue boat. So they come in white, yellow, red, green, blue, purple, and hot pink.
Hot pink?
Hot
Ooh.
Pink, that's for the girl.
Oh, the girls race them too?
Some of the girls do race.
It's not a guy thing?
That's exactly right. It sure is.
But these are a great boat for someone that wants to get into a competitive small class. They're $299 ready to run out of the box. So just go to minicatracingusa.com and we'll fix you right up.
Would you say this is beyond entry level, or would this be entry level?
No, this could be a good entry level boat.
Okay.
And if you put a different battery in it, they will go faster. And
so faster than that?
Oh, yes. Quite a bit faster than that. In fact, we'll probably run them again here in a little bit with the other batteries in them.
And we don't have them on the big lake today because it's too rough out there.
Too rough on the big lake, so we ran it on the little lake.
And it's kind of hard to take pictures of them out there when they're so far away, too.
Right. They do handle the waves quite well. It's really amazing. We ran them a couple of weeks ago on a lake that was really rough, and it really does handle it quite well. And it's a very efficient hull. It's a regular hydroplane, but it's got the extra step at the nose, keeps the nose up. Extremely stable. I was turning that boat just as far rudder as I could, and it just does not have any tendency to flip. It tracks like it's on rails. They're just a great little item.
MinicatRacingUSA.com.
And we carry all the parts. Something breaks, we have the outdrives, motors, the servos, the speed controls. We sell extra props. We sell everything except the hull. The hull does not come separate. You can only buy it with the equipment in it.
Now, what's the hull made of, Jim?
It's fiberglass.
So it's not going to break real easy,
no,
is it?
No,
it's pretty tough.
It's all fiberglass, and it's made with all high-premium American-grade epoxy resin.
Oh, cool.
And real fine weave fiberglass.
I do a little bit of work with aluminum. This is fine machined aluminum.
Nice,
this is really good work.
And some of the guys that are running some of the little electric boats, little outriggers and things, one of our guys have said that outdrive works beautifully on the little outriggers. So someone just wants to buy just the outdrive, we do sell those separate.
Okay. Is that a cable in there?
That's a cable. Flex cable drive.
Okay.
Right.
And there's your water cooling. I'm amazed that you got water cooling on such a small motor.
And as an upgrade right now, we offer a water cooled speed control. So yeah, they're really neat. They're selling like hotcakes. We've already sold out our first production run. We'll have another production run up and going in about 3 weeks.
This one of your batteries, Jim?
That is a nickel metal hydride battery pack, 9.6 volts. And this is a lithium polymer battery pack, 11.1 volts. So you put that in there, you're running another volt and a half.
Higher speed?
Quite a bit higher speed. Quite a bit higher speed. Now, I know the IMPBA, International Model Power Boat Association, that allows the LiPos, the lithium polymers right now. I'm not sure if NiMh does. North American Model Boating Association, but I've heard that they have changed the rules, and effective January 1st, they may be allowing these. So this is actually the battery of choice to me. It's faster, and it's got more volts, so it's gonna run that motor faster. But either one works fine. We probably will be having these batteries later on for sale. We don't have them right now. But there's a lot of sources for batteries.